One of the great things about Netflix, if we do say so ourselves, which we do, is that while you subscribe for all the stuff you know you like, this and some of this occasionally, every now and then an extra new thing comes along and you like that as well. The only problem being, how do you tell the new stuff that's for you from the new stuff that's for someone else? I'll tell you how. You say f*** on YouTube until someone explains it to you. Case in point, excuse me, could someone please explain what the f*** is The Queen's Gambit? The Queen's Gambit is a limited series about Beth Harmon, a young chess prodigy whose astonishing talent is discovered during her time in a mid-century American orphanage.
Well, you certainly know the game, young lady.
Orphanage? So she has it rough then. Beth contends with an austere upbringing, constant sexism.
Girls do not play chess.
And as her career takes off, addiction and mental illness.
I'm supposed to go to Russia, but what I want is a drink.
But the show is also about how the all-consuming game of chess can be a refuge for troubled minds and from the outside world.
I feel safe in an entire world of just 64 squares.
Where have I heard the title before?
The Queen's Gambit.
The Queen's Gambit is a famous chess strategy designed to put opponents under immediate pressure at the start of a game.
Those things are called openings.
It's also the name of the novel the series is based on, written by Walter Tevis, who also wrote the novels filmed as The Hustler, The Color of Money, and The Man Who Fell to Earth. Tevis said his book was partly about high speed and aggressive intelligence, which in his book he tried to present in the body of a young girl. Why do I know that lady's face? It's extremely distinctive. It belongs to Anya Taylor-Joy, who, as well as starring here as Beth, has also appeared in Peaky Blinders, M. Night Shyamalan Double Split and Glass, and was fantastic in last year's Jane Austen adaptation, Emma. What else do we need to know? Perhaps that The Queen's Gambit was developed and directed by Scott Frank, the veteran filmmaker who wrote Out of Sight, The Minority Report, and Logan, among many others, and created Netflix original western Godless. Oh, and The Queen's Gambit runs for a total of 7 episodes, all of which you can watch when it arrives on Netflix on the 23rd of October. Give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to keep up to date with everything on Netflix.